Hello, welcome back. Last time I got a really big sword and an Ormite shield via a route in this game that I think I actually want to keep instead of redoing. So I can finally use this cool equipment to make some forward progress. Very first thing I want to do is I want to see how I am doing against the Slayer. I could certainly go on a rampage and splatter all sorts of stuff. This is going to be slightly annoying because I'll be switching back and forth a lot between the Lucky Blade and the really big sword. Possibly even making some decisions to spend health for Greckles, depending on the ratio. But yeah, I need to know what I'm working toward here. Wubba dies. Great. 100 Greckles from that. Hi, Slayer.
Aren't you all supposed to be dead?
So collect up a little more health and I could totally kill him right now. Alright, he's hitting me 44 times. Two more attack would reduce that some amount. Alright, so 560, 310, 4500. Archivist had 500 defense, 800 attack, and 1000 HP? Am I remembering those numbers right? Well, it won't tell me because he's a character and doesn't turn into... Okay, I believe it was 1000, 800, 500. Now that the Slayer looks pretty manageable, it seems more plausible to be able to get the stats to do this. However, I still have the hand bomb if I need it. My sort of rough goal right now is to keep the hand bomb until the end of the hold. Doing that means that I know I could have spent it better. I'm currently picking up health in the hopes that I don't feel the need to take any Altlik hits. That basically locks away 200 Greckles in a place where I can't get it without spending way too much health. Maybe after a Slayer fight and my health is very low, I can take out those four Altlik in that one toll road hallway. As I have named it, that place is the toll road. I guess right at this moment, I will start leaving health on the ground until I'm ready to actually make this do the Slayer fight. And there's the health boost guy, who I don't need to see until after the Slayer, based on the amount of health that's on the ground and the amount of damage he's doing now, which will reduce once I... Defense 20, HP 360... No, you would still damage me, attack 310. You would not damage me anymore, so I could kill you with a Lucky Blade. Cool. Alright. Right, since my shield now works on Ormites. So what am I doing currently? I think I'm going Greckle hunting, right? I would want to buy, like, all of the upgrades before I take on either the Slayer or the Archivist. Yeah, Greckle and stat hunting. Because there's still a bunch of gems lying around at the ground. There are places where I can get them for free. Like, for example, behind that gel baby right over here. So let's go ahead and switch to the Lucky Blade and see what things I can kill with it here. Not Omplic yet. I mean, I could, but it would cost me health. But those are free. Great. Fagundos? Not quite. So, now that is a better than... That is a better trade than, two health for one Greckle. That's almost one-to-one. Because that's 63 health for 50 extra Greckles. Those may very well be worth doing. But there's zero reason to do it until I've gotten as much defense as I'm going to have before using the machine. And I don't know if I would use the machine on defense at all. I'm kind of going an attack route here. Pirates can't be hurt by the Lucky Blade. And that seems unlikely to change dramatically. Like, with the Lucky Blade, I'm not going to get to 390 attack. That would be way more upgrades than is ever going to happen here. So unless I wanted to take a bunch of damage from them... Hang on, how much... So 430 attack, 430 defense also is not going to happen. So yeah, that makes sense. Water skippers. What's the plausibility of water skipper lucky blade? Okay, so this is, maybe I shouldn't try so hard with this. It is fairly plausible that I would want to kill water skippers with the lucky blade. Especially since they give... Yeah, this is very nearly 1-to-1 health for Grekkles. 12 more attack, and it'll be almost 2-to-1 Grekkles for health. Or the other way. Whatever. Anyway, so that's going to be profitable by the valuation that I have chosen arbitrarily. You're going to stay there forever, probably. No, this is worth it by the point system, at least. Yeah, that's worth it. Okay, I'll consider that. What I should do is just go to the machine and buy some upgrades, because that'll make hunting around for this stuff easier. Alright, Pre-Slayer Machine 1, buy all of the attack.
Attack boosted. Have a nice day. Attack boosted.
Alright, so I only bought 20 more attack, but that's nice. It was 20 defense each. There are certainly possibly some circumstances where defense would be more worth it. Okay, so water skippers at this point with the lucky blade make a lot of sense. But any lucky blade kills I want to do should be deferred as long as possible so that I can get stuff like this. Unless it's on the way to getting it, so seep... Give a lot of Grekkles. I think that's worth it. It's also worth getting two more attack first. Which I don't have to get there, I can get here. Now, I did a calculation before where I decided to use the green key because of... Alright, so this lucky blade has given me an extra, rather annoying consideration. Because now I have to think about... Oh hey, you're... obnoxious to kill. How much damage would you do me like this? Oh, not that much. You're not so bad. Okay, right, so last time I did this, I tried this route and saw what it did to my points, then tried this route and saw... So let's do the same thing with the lucky blade, then the same thing with the really big sword. So 2450... 2431 is where I get if I do that. 2436 is where I get if I do that. So even with the lucky blade, right now, that's better. There's stuff I want to get first. I can get a little more shielding. If I did this, yeah, you would of course step into the outlook beam. Silly Tendry. Right. So I would have to fight a water skipper there and a pirate, but I would get... stuff out of it. Pirates are fought with really big sword because lucky blade can't damage them. Cool. Those things all seem good. But once again, let's leave the health there so that I can come back for a final collection after thingy. Now remind me, was it ever going to be plausible to kill Omtlik with lucky blade? 97 more attack? Unlikely. However, again, looking at the ratios here, that's worth it. Because that's 118 HP for 100 Grekkles. Let me know, anybody else who plays this game, if you think of Grekkles as a different value than that. Because again, I don't really have a good point of reference for how to value them. And it might change from hold to hold. It might change depending on where I am in the hold. Oh hey, this is a place I want to go. That's a place I want to go right now. Do I want to do this now? I can wait, I guess. This is only one hit, and that will save me zero hits, because pirates will not be hitting me, so no, that's not. To do the micro-optimization that I'm trying not to do too heavily here, this is still better. Another couple of hundred Grekkles, and I can get more... Oops. Get more machine upgrades. The place I want to be is... yeah, to the south, not north. No, it's not. This is not a place I want to be. Yes, it is. It's this room. Celiacs? The buttons for inventory and to use item are very easy to mix up. Yeah, no. I'm not going to seriously consider the idea of killing pirates at the Lucky Blade right now. I'm just going to assume that will not happen. Okay, so I got those upgrades. Which means, okay, right, so where are the gems to pick up? That's the information I need. I think I got all of them except that one shield gem over there, right? That is, okay, no, and this stuff. Okay, so two power gems, two shield gems, both right in that area. And that is all of the stats that are on the ground anywhere in the entire hold left to pick up, I believe. Yeah, barring any secret rooms that I didn't find or anything. Oh, hey. Right. So just in terms of ordering, shield gem, yeah, shield gem earlier. Shield gem before the largest number of hits. So I think that shield gem, no attack thresholds will be passing this shield gem, then this power gem. Okay. Seep goes splat, gel baby goes splat. This seep, right. I don't have to worry about this seep yet. That's surprisingly cheap for being disarmed. Wait a second. Fagundos are damaging me? That's right, Fagundos are damaging me. Not a big deal. Would this ever get better? It is unlikely. Feels like I want to do that. Yeah. Even if I don't, then that's barely a loss. There's nothing to have here other than a potion. So, actually, it occurs to me that this is in fact a point profit, because 1,000 health is worth more points than a green key. So maybe that does make sense. Okay, great. Great stuff. Everything is cool. My stats are boosted. I have picked up every gem that I know about in the entire hold. Ouch. So at this point, I should visit the machine again. Do I want to go into attack or start doing defense? I would like to know how I'm doing versus the Slayer. And there's a quicker way to do that. Somehow I input exactly the right moves to get through there without looking. Mr. Slayer, tell me about yourself. Let's get to know each other a little more. I can actually walk up and see you personally. 6240. So three more attack would save me some amount of damage. Possibly 208. Possibly more. No, it would have to be exactly 208, right? Because it would decrease the hit count by one. If it's going to decrease by multiple, then usually it says only one attack for faster win. I'm being really lazy about doing simple arithmetic in my head, but it takes just long enough that I feel like it's not worth doing while I'm recording stuff. So a defense upgrade at this point would save me a lot more than an attack upgrade. 30 hits. So 20 times 30, that I can do, of course, so that's 600. Okay, so that would... A defense upgrade at the machine would save me 600 health. An attack upgrade at the machine might save more than that if it crosses three hit thresholds. Would it? Let's find out. So he's hitting me 30 times. If I buy attack once, and that goes down to 27 or less, then attack is still worth more than defense for the Slayer, at least. Machine. I always forget where exactly the machine is.
Welcome to Design-O-Matic. Attack boosted. Have a nice day.
I made a quick save, so I'll reload it if he's still hitting me 28 or more times. Because at that point, it would be time to invest in defense. I should have checked how much the next machine usage would cost. I didn't think of it. It'll probably be around, like, 2,400 grekels. Okay, that is 28. So at this point, defense is better. Yeah, defense is better. Okay, so it's time to start investing in defense, I believe. Is there anything else I want to do at all? There basically isn't. 20 defense also will make some of the things that are hitting me once free now, because like water skippers or something were hitting for 18, weren't they? Something was hitting me for 18. So that, it was Fagundo with Lucky Blade, I believe. So that'll make those free to kill with Lucky Blade. So that'll be nice. Yeah, so this is kind of just like the
Welcome
very ending.
Design Nomadic. Defense boosted. Have a nice day.
I can always undo if I don't want that defense for some reason. Yeah, like this is how the game goes at the very end of a hold. It's just about optimizing the last few stats for the biggest gain. So yeah, water skippers are free. Seep still costs 8. So I might potentially be able to do better, so I'll avoid killing Seep for now. Oh, Fagundos do still cost 18. Okay, so I guess they were hitting me for 38 before? Huh, okay. Anyway, murder all water skippers. Where are water skippers? There's one. There's one. Don't murder Fagundo yet, because I probably will be buying 20 more defense, and I should have checked the price once again. I forgot. Murder all Omplic, right? No, not yet. Because, right, they do more damage, they take the same amount of attack, but I've made water skippers free via defense. Omplic, not so much. Switch to a really big sword, sure. Might as well since I'm here. I will not be killing you with a lucky blade. Right? If my health is low enough, that might make sense. Maybe. Okay, any more water skippers? Two gel babies, might as well get them now. I don't know why I didn't while I was in there. I think they were already free with the lucky blade. I just didn't think of it, I guess. I think I've... Okay, so there's one more water skipper. Okay, so spend yellow key, get yellow key, and get that stuff, which is nice. Okay. That's a place to go. Where am I? Right, yes. Going in there. That cost me nothing. Still leaving health on the ground just in case. Gel baby, yes, that will make sense. I'm not gonna bother yet. Actually, I should, because I know I want to open this. I know that the health is worth more. Here, 3808. 3823, yes. I will want that. I might not want it yet if I'm going to be doing Omplic stuff. Alright, so that was the last water skipper, right? I believe it was. I suppose I'll go ahead and kill those two gel babies since I'm in the area. Hold on a second. Why do I have a really big sword equipped? I made a mistake. Let's try this again.
Defense.
So... Well now, wait, I did it to block the Omplic beam in that one room. Okay, fine, let me redo that stuff. Alright, so got a Lucky Blade this time. I think I killed all the same monsters. Cool. So 2164 grekels. Let's just check the machine price so that I know what I'm aiming for. At this point, I'm sure, fairly sure, that guards will not cost me anything to kill with a Lucky Blade.
Welcome to Design
2420. Okay, I was almost exactly right. Alright, so 2420 is my next target. I keep forgetting about this shortcut down here. That's how you get to the machines quickly. Okay, so 18, sure. I want to buy defense one more time. Then Fagundos will be free, I'll be doing better against the Slayer, I'll be doing better against the Archivist. However... This is locking me out of the option of killing the Archivist with my sword. I've bought defense once, so I could have 473 attack at this point. That would mean I would still need to buy attack three more times, which is a lot of Grekkles. Possibly more Grekkles than are left in the world. And then I would only be doing 3 damage per hit to him, so that would be a very large amount of damage he was doing to me, like tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands, maybe even. So, yeah, I'm thinking I probably won't be stabbing the Archivist this run. Especially if I continue along the defensive route. That's a shame, but it just feels much better to go for defense now than attack. Well, it's not necessarily impossible that there would be enough Grekkles left to still make this work even having bought defense there. So I'm going to continue with what I'm doing here and see where it leads me. So I'm killing guards since I'm here, with the means to do so. I am using a lucky blade. I wanted to double check. Yeah. Squeezing less. Right, this is probably the reason that I don't have enough machine upgrades available to me to stab the Archivist. That is probably the single action that I took that made that unavailable to me. Using yellow key there doesn't make sense. Unless you give, like, a huge amount of Grekkles. So, 400... 510... 546. 546 Grekkles for a yellow key. Well, it certainly is better than the amount the guy would pay for them if I sold them to him, but I would never do that. 546 Grekkles for a yellow key. If I'm saying that a Grekkle is worth 2 health and a yellow key is worth 400, then by that ratio that would be worth it. But it really just depends on, like, if I'm just short of a machine threshold somewhere. Whether that would make sense to do. So we'll see. Once I've cleaned up everybody else, gotten all the Grekkles that are available here. Alright, so who's left? Not much. This is stuff I can mark off. This is another one of those things. Okay, so yellow key for how much? This is showing me non-lucky blade stats. No, this is showing me lucky blade stats, because it was 110 for the swordsman. Okay, so that's a much worse ratio. That's only 130 plus 240 Grekkles for a yellow key. No, never gonna be worth it. You get marked off. Mimic. I did not kill that mimic when I was there. Just a door. A potion that I might want someday, even though it's a tiny one. Ah, really? Mimic? Ah, you're the worst. I guess I can go all the way around to kill that mimic eventually. wow. Right, okay, so in addition to that, let's see, the way to go around involves homeland. So who's left out here? Anybody? This is no man's land. Slayer, of course. Lucky Blade would not have been able to kill the Wubba. And he only had 100 Grekkles, anyway. That gel baby. I'll kill that gel baby. Because I can do that now and not take damage. Not there. Over here. Splat. Great. Okay. So I believe that's No Man's Land completely cleaned up other than Slayer and Archivist, right? Yeah, there's nothing else to kill here. Okay. There's definitely... No, there is... Didn't I leave a tar baby in the goblin tribe who was in front of the health boost guy? Or did I actually kill him? I forget. There was one point where I didn't kill him because the lucky blade didn't instantly kill him, but no, I guess I did at this point. Okay. Alright, so things to remember. Percentage boost guy. Ooh, hey. So I forgot about him. Alright, so health boost guy here, I would want to do after Slayer if I'm fighting the Archivist. I'd want to do it, I don't need to do it before the Slayer. I would want to do it before the Slayer if I want to score points with higher health. The way I've optimized here, I don't think I care. I would replay this if I wanted higher scores. So I'll just accept whatever scores I get here, optimizing for long term. That guy does become useless if I'm not going to be able to kill the Archivist with my sword. Will that one defense upgrade that I bought cause me to be unable to do that? I wonder. What is my next action? With this number of Grekkles, my next action is, I guess, to see how I'm doing versus Slayer. Did I buy anything since I last saw him? I don't think I did. I just went and earned a bunch of Grekkles. So yeah, still 30 hits for 5640. I did buy that defense upgrade, so that's how much that did. More attack will save me, but now it's going to save me even less because I bought the defense. Hmm. 463. Do I want more attack? Kinda. If I ever want to damage the Archivist, I'm gonna need it. Man. One attack is worth 5 points. One defense is worth 3. No, don't think with points. Again, I'm not optimizing for that. So yeah, since defense is sold in twice the quantity as attack at a machine, it's more point efficient to take defense if you wouldn't be losing points by doing so. So at this point, I'm struck by indecision. What do I do? The nagging worry in the back of my mind, in the front of my mind now, really, is that, okay, right, I was going via Homeland to get to the other side of the thing, so I'll think while I do that. Yeah, the nagging worry in the front of my mind is that buying that defense has made the difference between being able to kill the Archivist with my sword and having to use the hand bomb on him. I mean, it doesn't extremely matter which one I do, and the hand bomb is actually going to give me a higher score anyway. It's just that it's more interesting to have a use for stuff like the health boost guy and the stat boost guy, because right now, I could just gather up a couple of the potions I've left behind and kill the Slayer with no trouble. Then go bomb the Archivist, see what's behind him. Hey, here's a possibility I haven't considered in a little while. Maybe those stairs behind the Archivist don't lead directly to an ending. Maybe there's more game beyond him. Okay, so that's worth thinking about. Alright, anyway, so I have a save. I know the specific save I want to come back to. It is Pre-Slayer Machine 2. Pre-Slayer Machine 2 is right before or after I bought that defense that I think might have made the difference. Yeah, so my inclination now is to spend my money on attack. In the hopes that buying that defense has not precluded me from killing Archivist. Like, he's going to be hitting me a lot of times, so... Well, but I'm over his defense threshold. If I bought attack 4 more times... Well, 3 more times, hang on. So, percent boost guy. I know I had business here, right? I was killing a mimic, that's right. Coming all this way just to kill one mimic with a lucky blade. Which, speaking of which, let's not forget to actually equip that. Although I do want to equip the other thing. Tell me about yourself. Tell me about myself. So, 13 and 11. So that's the amount I would get from him. Those numbers might go up by one if I use the machine again. Well, the attack number would at least. Okay, so let's say that's going to put me at 476, 486, 496, 506. So hitting the archivist for 6 damage each time. He has 800 attack. Yeah, no, that is and 1,000 HP, so that is an extremely large number of a little over 400 damage attacks on me. There's no way I would survive that. Well, okay. Okay, well, I have convinced myself that it is necessary to go back to the place where I bought defense from the machine. However, what I want to do right now is kill the Slayer, bomb the Archivist, and see what's beyond. Splat. Splat with the wrong sword. Yeah. And I left the room. I didn't quick save. Whatever. Anyway, so this is turning into kind of a hypothetical. Yeah. Final quick save now. Lost 45 Grekkles, potentially, from the Mimic. That's super annoying. My last save was that quick save. And then Pre-Slayer Machine 2. Okay. Oh, this is hard. Not gonna kill Umplik. At least not till after Slayer. Slayer was doing 5,600, a little more than 5,600 on me. Right. So where have I left little bits of health? Not on this floor, apparently. Right, and if I want to go that way, I go this way. Sure. So I want to pick up a little bit more health. I made a quick save there. I'll make one a little later. Pick up just enough health to kill the Slayer, go bomb the Archivist, and see what's down those stairs. Because, like, if that is the end of the hold, then I think I want to go back to Pre-Slayer Machine 2, buy attack instead, and see if I can make that work. Remind me how I'm doing versus Omplik using this. 78. So that's 100 Grekkles for 78 damage, which is a good ratio. If. It's a good ratio if it pushes me over a threshold to be able to use the machine once more. That's the real question. Fagundos? My stats haven't gone up. They're still going to hit me for 18. Right. I know what this is. I know what the numbers are. I'm going to use the machine once more. This is a shortcut to the machine? No, that's not a shortcut to the machine. That's a shortcut to another place. Well, there's some health. There we go. That's a means to kill the Slayer. Let's just do that. Let's just do that without thinking about anything else. To gain the knowledge of what is behind the Archivist. Sure, did a quick save in some random place. Doesn't matter. Killing Slayer, killing Archivist, seeing what's under this, past the stairs. I did not take into account the Slayer's extra hit on me. This will kill me. Just barely. Fine. I need a little more health. So who has a little more health? Plenty of people have a little more health. Is there any here? Yep. Heck, that's probably enough. Sure, another 250 is plenty. Okay, Slayer again. All the vibration amused me. Ooh, 70%. Well, that score went up. I didn't take the health boost guy. I didn't take the attack and defense boost guy. Whatever. Just tell me about what's behind the Archivist. That is what I need to know.
So, you found me.
I must
admit, you caused us some inconvenience.
And I'm going to use a bomb on you. Cannot harm this dangerous enemy. Yeah, so it is 1,000, 800, and 500. I remembered those correctly. What the... Oh, wrong button.
We'll be back.
What the? Okay. I guess I don't kill him. Well, of course I don't, because he has to... Is this a bonus level, or is it an ending? It's the end. Where did the archivist run off to? Sure, I can tell you all about that, but first there's something I need to do. Hey! 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 What the... Hey. No. Fine, defeated Slayer, autosave. Thank you for autosaving there, because I did not think that going down those stairs would lock me out of stuff.
So, who found...
It seems as if there is more game.
We'll be back.
So for convenience, let's quick save here. Not that that's a long way after the Slayer save. Oh, wait, this might be nothing.
My nose, it speaks to me. I must share my creation with the world. There's nothing left. I killed them all. Except myself. The odds, the walls, and I say the floors are still intact, and the ceilings are fine, and the walls are on track.
This is like when Denfrey makes up a song.
But I killed a whole lot, but I killed. I have killed. I killed lots. I killed lots. I beat the living things, the unforgiving things. I guess I left some things like that guy. And that other one.
Regardless!
It's the end. It's the end of the game. It's the end. No more goblins to name. There will be books about the times when I went out and proved myself devout to my own blade. I'm the best. I'm the best at my game. I'm the best.
How long is this?
I did every last thing except die. Did not die.
Oh, that happened a few times.
No death here.
Wow.
Well, maybe once or twice.
So, Tendri did not spend his time practicing that craft since his father pressured him into being a stalwart. He's definitely a lot better at this point at being a stalwart than a lyricist or whatever. I guess that wasn't so bad, but still. Like I said, it reminded me most of Denfrey's song about the fuse is the key. So I guess that's the end. Hey, look at that multiplier. That's nice. Okay, so I bombed the archivist. I don't feel like... Here's my feeling. I think that if I were to go back, try to squeeze every last Greckle out of everything, even go back and buy attack instead of defense, get all the health everywhere, I think I would still come up short of being able to kill the archivist without the bomb. That's my feeling. I would need to optimize things a little bit differently, keep more Greckles available, get the lucky blade earlier, don't waste Greckles on green keys in that one room.
That is how.
Yeah.
Sturdy little. Ah, brother.
Yep. Yep. I think. This bothers me greatly. Is the invisibility potion, for example, in a secret that I didn't find? See, now hang on. You know, invisibility potion. Invisibility potion drops monster defense to zero. If I could find one of those, Archivist would go down much, much easier. But I shouldn't see any other cracked walls in places. Maybe there's other stuff I can get to with, like, flippers or grappling hook or something. Man, I don't know. Yes, I've already seen this. Alright, well, that's Tendry's tale. Mysteries still remain. Unlike a normal drought game, I will... Wait a second. Those could totally be secrets in... Oh. Okay, so it's actually 87%. It's just that in that save, I had not gone to, like, the, Yeah, a few of them. Anyway. Some of those could have also been in part one. I just realized. Yeah. Wow. A lot of them will have been in part one because I missed an entire secret level. Okay. So anyway, mysteries still remain. I'll undoubtedly be replaying this game on my own time. I don't expect I'll do more videos of this hold other than a redo of part one to find Rule 8. That's definitely something I'll be doing. I have some ideas about where it is, but not complete information about that, so please don't tell me. But I'll definitely figure that out. Whoopsie. Hey, look, I'm doing it right now. Apparently.
I'm a dick.
No. Yeah. So, I will find wherever Rule 8 is. I have a decent idea of where to look, but I have not actually found it yet. Anyway, cool. So that's the complete story of Tendry's Tale. I'll probably also be doing other holds in Drought RPG at some point. I don't know when. But yeah, let me just worry about finishing Tendry's Tale, part one all the way first. All right, I'll see you next time for part one redo.